It's wonderful to be here with my brother, Bishop Jugos from Charlotte, with my brother priest from the Diocese of Charlotte and Raleigh, our seminarians, many religious men and women, and all of you who make time today to come to pray and say what the Psalms say today, that all of us, we can sing and say, I praise you, for I am wonderfully made. If we think in the power of that psalm, and we see how God created us, he made me, made us, how high we can jump of joy. That is one of the important things that we need to realize in our lives. Find joy and see who we are. Because we need to celebrate life. And how we celebrate life? With joy. We cannot have a celebration with sadness. We celebrate with joy. And my question is this: how joyful are you with yourself? How much joy you find in the gift of who you are? Jesus in the gospel is a beautiful gospel. He cured the sick, he healed the wounded, he expelled demons. And how many times Jesus has been doing that with all of us, all our life, with kindness, compassion, mercy, and love. Are we grateful for all the great things that God has been doing through Jesus in our own lives? All the many times that he forgave our sins. How we give thanks to him for that kindness, for that love, for that mercy. I praise you, for I am wonderful made. It's an ad in TV who says, I have four sons. My youngest one is Bruno, who is 13 years old. And Bruno is a dog. I don't know if you see that ad in TV. But he's not the only one who give animals the dignity of a person. And maybe we can say, oh, that is cute. No, it's not. It's not cute. Another one is a lady who is asking to her dog, come, kiss your mama. When we see this, we are so confused. And that is why we don't understand the value of the human being. We are not pets. We are human beings created by God because of love. When we don't understand this, and we start to be like dogs and animals, being in the same plate, we don't understand that life is sacred, is precious, because we treat person as we treat dogs. And that is wrong. And that is the challenge, my brothers and sisters, today, that we need to find the true meaning of what is love. How many things you love in life? How many things you love in life? Start to count. Pizza. And when you say that, look at that, what happened. Immediately, you smile. It's the reaction of that. But how we can compare love of pizza with love for God? We put pizza and God in the same level. We don't make a difference anymore. And we don't understand the value of the human person anymore, because pizza, cars, people, God, we put them in the same level, in the same page. And that is why we don't get it. And we don't understand how precious is life from the beginning until the end, and everything in between. That is our, they need to be our mission. Jesus said to his disciples, we need to move forward. We need to bring the good news to the people, not only here, but everywhere. And how is the mission that God gave us today? To preach the respect of life and the dignity of the human person. When we made the difference about what truly means love, the emptiness of love is death. The fruit of love is life. That is the key. Yes, I like my car. I enjoy eating pizza. Wonderful. But love is only for God and for your brothers and sisters and yourself. Period. No más. Punto. Eso es todo. You get it? Love is only for God. For your neighbor and for yourself. Not for pizza. Not for your car. Not for your garden. Not for your flowers. It's only for God, your neighbor, and yourself. That is when we found and see the beauty of who we are, because we are loved. And the person who find that is love, that is loved, respect life. Aversion is the lack to understanding that a person never feel that we love it. And that is our mission, how we preach, how we, with our lives, not too much with words, but with life, the joy of being loved. That we are loved in every Mass when we receive the Eucharist. Jesus come to us, give his life, and we need to go out with that joy to share that. I use many times the example, if you go to a good restaurant, and at the end of that meal, you go out and you are preaching how good was that place. With your face, with your actions, when you feel someone and find someone, you say, go to that place, the food is great, it's awesome. But how we preach, how we are sent to the people to preach the dignity of the human person, the joy of our faith, the joy of the love in which God created me. We Catholics are good to say at the end of the Mass was too long, 1 hour and 1 minute. It's not joy. Was too long. Was too long to be loved? No, it was too short. Yes, protect the unborn. But first, we need to begin with our own selves. Surrender who we are in the arms of the one who really loves us. Feel how important are we when Jesus embraced me, kissed me, and hugged me in every Eucharist and talked to me. And let me see how wonderful I was made by him. And that joy is what the people outside are looking to see in us. The joy of what we believe. The beauty of our life. And the respect of the human person. From the beginning until the end and everything in between. Jesus is present in every Eucharist. As he was in his time, healing the wounded, expelling the demons, and make us a joyful people, free of sin, and heal of our wounds in our souls. Respect of life, we only can go there as far as we know how much we are loved by Jesus. Everyone who fell in love never need to tell and say anybody that is in love, because his actions or her actions are good enough to see the joy in that face. The people, when we leave the Mass, they see, they are able to see in us that joy, that we are praising God with our actions because we were wonderfully made. The people outside, the world outside of this church, are waiting for the good news. And what is the good news that they are waiting for us? Tell them, praise because you have been wonderful made. And tell that person, I love you. Boom. Reach the heart, give life, and make a difference. We are God's instruments to bring good news to the people that don't have hope. The people that maybe have life, but they don't know how to enjoy life. The people who have problems to accept the unborn. They need to know, first and most, that they are loved. And love gives life.